Neapolitanism! Oh! In munificently mellifluous miscellany! Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, the Players Theatre! Welcome to Miss Anna Sharkey!
Once there lived a very martial maid, the only daughter of a grand duke she. By her nurse in uniform arrayed, she was a soldier at the age of three. Day by day, the small princess paraded in a helmet of the past. She was there upon the barrack square as captain of the 55th Hussars. She was the captain. till 17, she took command of that heroic band. Victories like hers were never seen. Her charms were such no four could well withstand. Every heart that by her glance was wounded, gloried in such well and scars. Every eye was captivated by the colonel of the 55th Hussars. She was the colonel of the Crimson Hussars. When on the battlefield her eyes shone like stars, as with her cheeks aglow, she vanquished every foe. She was the colonel of the Crimson
Hussars. Inordinate, instrumental inexhaustibility. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Marty Stewart!
Thank you very much. I would now, with the help of this little piece of rubber hose, endeavour to give you an impression. This is my impression, ladies and gentlemen, of a Boys' Brigade bugle band. Company! Company attention! Company! Fire the left! Quick! Walk! Instrument called a tubophone. I hope you know the words to this particular tune. If so, please join in. 3, 4. Wonderful. It's your turn now. Thank you very much. Let's see your sing now.
La, 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 la.
Listen, all.
The zenith of esoteric cultural indoctrination, that redoubtably indomitable duplicity, Dr. Evadne Hinge and Dame Hilda Bracket!
Very nice indeed. And thank you for bringing us on so nicely, Mr. Helmut.
Thank you, yes, yes. All right, yes.
Yes, I'm very well. Thank you. I must say that it is really wonderful for the doctor and myself to be back here with you all this evening. You all look splendid, don't you?
Don't they?
So colourful. Makes me feel quite shabby. What we thought would be rather nice this evening would be to give you a little piece of Gilbert and Sullivan. Now, we have to decide which piece, shall we? Now, what we have actually chosen for you is a lovely song from the Gondoliers. Oh, 'tis a glorious thing, I ween,
to be a regular royal queen.
Then one of us will be a queen and sit on the golden throne, with a crown instead of a hat on the head and diamonds all her own, with a beautiful robe of gold and green. I've always understood.
Yes, I know. And you see, I've got one coming up in a minute.
God moves in a mysterious way. I wonder whether she'd wear a feather.
I wonder.
I rather think she should.
Oh, tis a
glorious thing I win to be a regular royal queen. No, half a fair, I weep, no half and half a fair, but all right, I'm regular royal queen. She'll ride around in a carriage and pair with a king on her left hand side, with a milk white horse as a matter of course whenever she wants to ride, with beautiful silver shoes to wear. Oh, up all of her dainty feet. That's the other lovely note, you see. Pretty, isn't it? Very nice indeed, yeah. Very nice, thank you. Lovely, dear, thank you very much. Very reminiscent of Lillian Bayliss, I thought.
She didn't sing there.
An endless stocks of beautiful frocks. She wants to eat. Oh, 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 glorious thing I win to be a regular royal queen. No half and half a fair I win, no half and half a fair, but all right, I'm regular royal queen. Oh, tis the glorious thing I win to be a regular royal queen. All right, darn regular wonderful form. I think really we should do something now where we can ask you to join in. Would you like that?
Yes!
The song we have chosen, we won't tell you what it's called, but we think you'll know it. In fact, we're sure you will, because we've all sung it at school, I think. It's a pretty hat. Very nice, dear. A lot of work in that. Yeah, now, what?
there's no more. Oh, and Mr. Berman, what we would like to do is if we could have the use of you and your instruments, sort of. Yes, oh, thank you. Nice man, isn't he?
Yes, sweet man, dear.
Funny he's never married.
Well.
Transcendental intrepidity. Oh. Vertiginously vortiginous. Oh. Virtuosity. Miss Enger Lees. Oh.
Thank you. miracle, eh? Unique, bewitchingly breathless blandishments of that phenomenally far-fabled... It says F's. Femme fatale, Miss Fenella Fielding!
Only a glass of champagne, but it led a poor girl into sin. A glass of champagne was the door where the devil crept in. Here is the picture, a man and a girl. Strolling along through the shade. He is a marquis, the son of an earl. She is a pure village maid. He tells her he loves her again and again. She thinks he is loyal and true. And then comes the night when he gives her champagne. And he does what he ought not to do. Only a glass of champagne, but it led a poor girl into sin. Only a glass of champagne was the door where the devil crept in. It's just an old story, it's always the same. Just like a poor moth, she flew too near the flame. She opened her wings and she lost her good name. All through a glass of champagne. Think of her future. The sorrow and shame, neither a maid nor a wife. Yes, just a little more, please. Think of her parents who gave her the name that she has dishonored for life. What's to become of her? Spurned and reviled, into oblivion hurled. Oh! And what can she offer the fatherless child that she has brought into the world? Yes. Only a glass of warning from her. If you're taken out by a lord or a sir, be careful you don't let the same thing occur. Just for a glass of champagne. Oh no, you must insist on at least of champagne. I don't know why I am so very shy. I always was demure. I never knew what silly lovers do. No flirting I'd endure. In all my life, I've never kissed a man. I've never winked my eye. But now, at last, I'm going to break the ice. So how would you like to try? How do you like to spoon with me? How do you like to spoon with me? Sit beneath an oak tree, tall and shady, calling me your mootsy, mootsy baby. How do you like to hug and squeeze? Dandle me upon your knees. How do you like to be my lovey-dovey? How do you like to spoon with me? How do you like to be my lovey-dovey? How would you like to spoon beneath the sunny moon? How would you like to spoon with me?
Delineator of dubieties, the one and only Mr. Larry Grayson.
All right, common as muck. How are you? Do you know? All right, Leonard. I see your candles alight.
Always.
Always. He's anybody's for a tin of salmon. Do you know? Now wait, wait a minute. Oh no, listen. I've got to sit down. Ooh. Oh no, no, honestly, no. Play the game or leave the bed. Do you know? Now, listen. What have I been like all day today? Speak.
Enchanting.
Oh, well. How are you? Know your face ever so well. Oh, is that your wife? Yes. Listen, now listen. You're too good for her. Now listen to this. He wears a wig. Do you know? How I got out of bed this morning, I shall never know. If I live to be 32. Do you know, I got... Oh, you see, actually, last week, I had it all down this side. I couldn't get the beef tea to my lips. Now, this week, I've had it all down this side. Can't wait for next week, can I? And you know, nobody knows. I got up, don't stare, it's very rude. I got up the other morning and I went all limp. No, I think it's the brown bread. And I was like... And I thought to myself, I thought, I'll go... My hair wants washing. I thought... You're very near, aren't you? And I thought... I thought I'd go and see my doctor. I've got a new doctor now. Got a lovely new doctor. Eh? What did you say to him then? Oh. Who's she? Anyway, I said... Do you know, I used to... Years ago, I told you, Leonard, about when I used to rub my legs with Fiery Jack. Don't you remember it? No, no, Leonard, really, no, honestly, have you heard of Fiery Jack, Bernard? Well, it's the truth, Fiery Jack. You can't get it now, I've got his address. But, I see you've got a new drummer. You get nothing here. All right, now, what we'll do... A little song about a girl that went astray. And this girl came from Burnley, and she's a lovely... Are you from Burnley?
Yeah.
I thought so. Riff raff. All right, now, we'll... We'll do it. We'll do it. She was young, she was pure, she was sweet, she was nice, she was fair, she was sweet 17. He was old, he was vile, and no stranger to vice. He was bold, he was base, he was mean. He slyly inveigled her up to his flat to view his collection of stamps. Then he smiled as he hastily put out the cat, his cigar, the wine, and the lamps. Have some Madeira, my dear. You really have nothing to fear. I wouldn't try to tempt you, that wouldn't be right for you to drink spirits this time of night. Have some Madeira, my dear. It's really much nicer than beer. I'm not fond of sherry, I never drink stout. And port is a wine I can well do without. It's simply a case of go blimey me gout. Have some Madeira, my dear. Unaware of the snake that creeps in the grass, of the fate of a lady who topes, she lowered her standards by raising a glass, her courage, her eyes, his hopes. She drank it, she sipped it, she drained it, she did, and he slyly refilled it again. And he smiled as he secretly carved one more notch on the butt of his gold handle cane. Poor wench. Have some Madeira, my dear. I have a small flask of it here. Now, once it's been opened, you know it won't keep. So do drink it up. It will help you to sleep. Have some Madeira, my dear. It's really an excellent year. Now, if it were gin, you'd be wrong to say yes. The evil gin does would be hard to assess. In fact, it's inclined to affect my prowess. Tell her. Have some Madeira, my dear. Don't want me out sweats, come on. Yeah. Through her mind came a flash what her mother had said. with an altipenitumate breath. My child, beware on the wine when it's red, or your face a fate worse than death. She lets go her glass with a shrill little cry. Ooh! I think I'll do that again. Ooh! Crush, tinkle, it fell to the floor. He said one, what on earth? And she made no reply. In a dash, as she went for the door, run. God, I'm so giddy again. Have some Madeira, Madeira. Rang out down the hall loud and clear. And when she got out there with a shrill little cry, she knew not what to do, well, neither did I. I can't place you at all. Are you an insurance man? Have some Madeira, Madeira. Rang out in her ear loud and clear. Until the next morning she woke up in bed with a smile on her lips and an ache in her head and a beard in her ear all that tickled and said, have some Madeira, Madeira. Have some Madeira, Madeira. Please.
It's just time to ask Mr. Larry Grayson to lead the company and yourselves in the last chorus for tonight down at the Old Bull and Bush. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Larry Grayson, the entire company, Mr. Bernard Herrmann, the entire and absolutely invincible orchestra. But this time, chiefly, your...